Hello everyone, welcome to the history class. In this video I'll be covering the second theme of class 11th history, that is writing and the city life. Now talking about the writing and the city life, in this entire theme we'll be focusing on the Mesopotamian civilization. First of all, just a brief introduction about the civilization. This civilization flourished in the land between the river Euphrates and river Tigris, that is now part of present Iraq. The civilization is known for its prosperity, rich literature, mathematics and astronomy. The southern region of the civilization was called Sumer and Akkad. After 2000 BCE, Babylon became an important city. Assyrians established their kingdom in the northern region, and they then came to be known as Assyria. The first known language was Sumerian. Later it was replaced by Akkadian. Changes came in language with the time, like Aramaic also trickled in, which was very similar to Hebrew, and this Hebrew language was widely spoken after 1000 BCE. Archaeology in Mesopotamia began in 1840s. It was important for the Europeans because of the references to the Old Testament, the first part of the Bible. It has references of Shimer, meaning Sumer, a land of brick-built city. Later, the interest was shifted to other questions like when the civilization flourished, how it ended, the expanse of the civilization, etc. Now, talking about the Mesopotamia and its geography, in this map you can see the exact location of Mesopotamia, important cities of Mesopotamia. Now, talking about its geography, Mesopotamia, Iraq is a land of diverse environment. In the northeast lie undulating green plains, trees covering mountain ranges. Agriculture began between 7000 to 6000 BCE. In the northern region, steppe grasslands are there, so supporting the animal herding activity. To the east, the tributaries of river Tigris provided routes of communication into the mountains of Iran. In the southern region, there is a desert. Cities and writings developed here first. River rises in the northern mountains carrying lots of silt. When they flood or when their water is let out onto the fields, fertile silt deposited here. River Euphrates, when entered in desert, its water flows out in small channels, which were used as canals for irrigation. It was thus the agriculture was most productive in southern region. Beside the fact that this region does not have sufficient rainfall to grow crops, variety of food grains plus meat is as they do animal herding, date palm grown on desert region, and fish which were available in rivers were part of their staple diet. Now we'll change the topic to the significance of urbanism. Now the cities, apart from the food production, cities also develops when economy flourishes in different spheres other than the food production, like trade, manufacturers and services. Some of the important features of urban city life was interdependence of the people on each other, large population, people engaged in different economic activities, particularly in some specialized crafts, presence of a social organization to look after the proper functioning of the society, etc. Now to understand these features, when we talk about specialized crafts and organized authority to look after the proper functioning of the different activities in states, then try to understand it with an example. A beautiful worker head. Picture of this is given in the book. You can see here also a woman's head was sculpted in white marble at Uruk. Uruk is an important city of Mesopotamia before 3000 BCE. Lapis lazuli, a blue precious stone, was used for making eyes and eyebrows. shells and bitumen inlay respectively. This is admired for its delicate modeling, which was done on headstone, hard stone that would have been imported from distant land. So think about the list of specialists who would be involved from the beginning with the procurement of the stone to the production of such a piece of sculpture. So this shows that the specialized craft activities were, people were engaged in such activities, how different specialists were involved in performing such great task. Now talking about the movement of goods into the city, Mesopotamia was rich in food production, but it was having less mineral resources. They lack in stones which were required for making tools, seals and jewels. Hardwood which was required to make cart wheels, boats, metal for tools, vessels or ornament. So they lack in these things. They exchange their abundant textile agricultural produce for wood, copper, tin, silver, gold, shells, stones. These were the items that were exchanged, and they were doing trade with Turkey and Iran. Besides crafts, efficient transport is also important for urban development. They have used river routes for traveling and carrying their goods to transport to distance.